Hello, Total Rock. It's me, Jeff Leach. I'm joined here by the very gorgeous Dean from Theory of a Deadman. How are you, sir? You all right?
I'm well.
We're just discussing the weather, aren't we? Which is a bit obvious.
Kind of reminds me of home.
Which is obviously Vancouver. Is it this kind of chilly out there at the moment?
No, I don't think so. I think we're actually getting some sunshine, and I get to go home tomorrow, so, you know, go home.
So you don't care, really? You're like, fuck it. One more day of this misery, and then I'm back to home.
One more day. Yeah, exactly.
And I was discussing your amazing outfit, but you've literally bought everything afresh, ready for it to get covered in mud.
Yeah, we heard that it was a mud pit down here, so we stopped at the Tesco and I bought 7-pound shoes to go in the garbage as soon as we pack up and leave.
That's professional attitude towards a festival.
Yeah.
Now, you guys, obviously, you've got the, I think it's time for the fifth studio album, really. You seem to have, like, 3 years in between every album. What happens in that 3 years?
Well, there's usually 2.5 years of touring.
Yeah.
And then we try not to write on the road, you know, solely because we don't want to go right in the studio. You need some time off.
Yeah.
So, I think we're booked till the end of the year, and then we'll see what happens there.
Well, I mean, the last one was obviously 2011, so 2014, is that when we expect the fifth one?
I guess so, yeah. Yeah, we'll see how it goes.
And what, I mean, do you have like a rigmarole you always go through leading up to that? Because it's like year one, obviously, touring it around the old album, the previous album.
Yeah.
Second year is, you know, falling out with each other and hating each other. Third year is getting back and being friends again and going, all right, fuck, let's write some more music.
Nah, well, it's sort of along that lines, but we have been together for 10 years now, and we still get along like brothers, so we're still having a lot of fun with it. But we'll see. I think maybe the new year we'll start to calm down and start to think about new material.
Well, you guys have been together for quite a few years, and I think that any band seems to have breakups and get back together, and that's probably because it's quite a stressful relationship being on tour. How do you guys sort of stay friends? How do you reinvigorate your friendship as well as you work?
I think it's just a good sense of humor. We're all light-hearted guys, and like to poke fun at each other. And
7-pound shoes, man. I mean, it's gonna happen, isn't it?
Exactly. Yeah. Just grow a thick skin, too.
Yeah. And obviously, you guys are from Canada. Do you prefer playing shows over there, or do you like the UK crowd? Because we're a bit more up for it, right? Canadians are very peaceful people.
Yeah. No. I'm so excited to play today. The UK crowds are nuts. Like, there's so much fun to play in front of, and I find over here, they're so knowledgeable with our whole material.
Yeah.
Whereas over in North America...
Every lyric, singing it out.
Yeah, right? It's more single-based over in North America, where they know the songs that are on the radio. But over here, they really get into the whole record and know all the
It's a very British attitude towards music, you know, sort of going, oh, we're going to find out about this band, and then we're going to find out everything they've done, learn
exactly.
It. We're music geeks, I guess.
Yeah, no, it's awesome.
Do you like seeing people in the crowd singing your lyrics then when you're up on stage rocking out? Is that a nice feeling,
absolutely.
Or is it a bit fucking creepy? Like,
no. And the one thing over here, everybody's got great timing.
Okay.
Yeah, so they don't throw you off. Everybody can clap in time and sing in time.
That's one of my pet peeves, you know, when a band sort of get everyone start clapping and it's way out of time. Yeah. But there's always some dickhead who speeds up and then everyone just goes, yeah, follow that guy.
Yeah. It screws us up too.
So there's going to be a bit of clapping over this weekend then?
I would imagine so, yeah.
And listen, look, a pun on your bloody name, but I'm going to do it. Theoretically, if you had to kill a man, how would you kill a man? How would you make that man dead? Theoretically. See what I did there? Theory of a dead man. It's, you know, it's mind-breaking, mind-blowing comedy.
I've never thought of this before. I don't know.
You seem like a lovely, peaceful guy, Dean, but if you had to kill a man, how would you do it?
With many hookers and a lot of drugs and alcohol.
So that he died happy?
Yeah, absolutely.
Or just in a pit of misery and despair and shame?
That could be too, yeah.
He's a killer. So is the band. Check him out. Theory of a dead man. Thanks very much. Cheers, Dean.
Right on.
Nice
Thank
one,
you.
Brother.